Welcome to Growing Craft. Do not forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon for all the new uploads. Finally, I did this fabric decoupage and I'm so happy with the way it had turned out. And yes, I had to share this video tutorial with you all, and how can I miss that? So welcome back to my channel, friends. This is Sonia here from Growing Craft, and today I have this tutorial where I'm doing decoupage with fabric. So these are the basic supplies. A few other supplies also I will be needing. But to start with, I am going to prep up my base with gesso. Now, this is the first time I'm doing a decoupage with fabric. So I just wanted to make sure that I have not missed out any of the supplies, and I did not want to take any risk with the look and feel of my project. I'm really sorry for this cup of coffee in my screen, because I'm really down with cold and cough. So I need to have a cup of coffee while making this tutorial. Now, to prep up my base, I'm using gesso, like I said, and I'm using a white gesso, and I'm going to do this on both the front and back side of these coasters, and I'm going to apply a good thick coat of gesso for my coasters. And yes, I will be doing the decoupage with fabric only on the one side, and on the other side I will be using my chalk paint. To have my proper color, I thought I should add white color to it, because my MDF base and gesso on the top of it, it's still not that white as it looks on the screen. So I had to use my acrylic white paint, and I'm applying my paint with my paint brushes, because the area in which I'm working is really small. So taking out my sponge dauber was something which I thought will not work out. So paint brush is going to work really well in this project. For sticking my fabric, I am going to use my matte finish Mod Podge, and yes, I need to tear it into two pieces. So here I am using my scissor to cut off the pieces into two halves so that my sticking work becomes easier. I am going to apply a generous amount of Mod Podge and then stick my cloth on this, and I just want to make sure that I stick really well so that when I'm using my sandpaper and when I have to tear off the extra fabric, it becomes easier for me. It's time to cut off my extra cloth. So here I'm using my paper cutter, and with this I'm going to trim it out. I thought I will do it with scissor, but then I thought this is going to work really well because I can actually cut it from the edges and my sanding work will give a nice finishing to this. So I am going to use my paper cutter and remove all the extra cloth from the edges. Just be careful when you are using your paper knife because it actually is very risky, and just be careful when you are doing it. So my cutting work is done, and this is my sandpaper which I'm going to cut it into small pieces and I'm going to use it. So the method is same. You need to do it from your fabric or the paper to the base and just slide it down, rub all the extra portions. The threads will come out, but don't worry, if your sandpaper is good, it will just trim off the threads from that portion. And I'm going to repeat the same process on both the coasters and around all the sides and corners of my coasters. My sanding is done and it looks really, really good. And now it's time to use my chalk paints. It's been so long that I've used my chalk paints. Like, I've been playing a lot with my acrylic colors nowadays. And I knew I had this shade and I really wanted to do something really similar. So instead of adding my black, white colors to it, I just thought I'll go with the gray color. And this just worked really well here. So here I am going to have my colors on both the coasters and the back side. The front and back side is done, but I really need to color up on the edges also. Yes, the coaster has some thickness and the natural color, brown color was there, but I had to add my gray color to it. And for this, I'm using my very thin brush. It's a 000 brush, and with that, I will cover both the coaster's edges really well. Sealing is really, really important, and here I am again going to use my matte finish Mod Podge, and I'm going to apply a generous amount of Mod Podge. The reason why I love Mod Podge is because it's transparent. It really gives a nice look and adds so much of strength to your project that's the reason it lasts so long. So here I'm going to have a coat of Mod Podge before applying my varnish to my project. My Mod Podge has dried out and it's time to add varnish. So here I'm starting with the back side because this varnish dries up really, really fast. So I'm just going to apply a coat. By the time I end up second one, the first one is going to be almost dry, and that's why my work is going to be really easier. And I am also going to use off screen my heat gun to speed up the drying process. Yes, during this complete video I have used my heat gun to speed up the drying process so that I can finish this project really fast. But for the varnish, once you are done with your one coat of varnish, after 3 days make sure you do one more coat of varnish so that it lasts long. And with this my project is done, and this is how it looks, and it's totally amazing. You can just go to the market, select the patterns and the designs you get, and you can create varieties of coasters and beautiful artwork for your home. So with this my project is done, and I have listed down all the supplies down in the description box. Do check that. If you have any queries, please do comment below. And yes, please do not forget to subscribe to my channel, hit the like button and share it with your friends. Thank you so much for watching. Take care. Bye bye.